little discussion about graphing when you're doing analysis of variance. So when you're doing your analysis of variance, and in this case we've got farm products, whether there's cows, horses, or pigs grown on this on these farms, a column that has the expenses per animal and the return per animal. That's how much they make per animal. So let's go ahead and graph those. And we can graph them before we do our statistics. So sometimes it'll get us a better idea of what we're seeing when we actually see our statistics. So graphing, of course, is on the graph button. And when we're comparing means of two or more items in our commander, we use the boxplot function. So click OK. We want the amount of return per animal. We want to plot it by farm products. It's supposed to be products, not product 5. We can put our plot labels. What is raised on your farm or ranch? The y-axis is profit per animal in, we'll say, Bitcoin. And the graph title is Box Plots for R Commander Practice. Why not? And then click OK. And here we get our nice little snazzy little box plot. Let me make it a little bit prettier by putting some colors into it. And the color, you can just put a comma here at the end after the last parentheses quotation mark and hit color, C-O-L, equal sign. And then since we have three, we need to put three different colors. So we have to use the concatenate, C left parentheses, O, let's do pink, quotation marks around the pink, yellow, quotation marks around the yellow, and green. And again, quotation marks around the green. And then we need to have our closing parentheses. And we'll hit submit. And that'll give us some color in our world. Okay, so here is our lovely little box plots. Let me make it bigger so it's more visible. And what we can see here is that we have a line, I mean a series of boxes that have a line, a heavy line in the middle, and it has tails with little lines, lighter lines on the ends of them, and then they got these occasional little dots out here with numbers beside them. So let me kind of systematically go through what each one of these things are. So the heavy line in the middle of these three are the mean for pigs, horses, and cows from right to left. So we can see that the mean of pigs and horses aren't that different, but that the mean for pigs and cows and pigs and horses are different from cows. Although we want to be careful to announce them as different, because we can see that the mean lies within this colored range. And so what does that mean? Well, that means that the mean lies within one standard deviation below the mean of horses, and it looks like it also is within one standard deviation of the mean of pigs, although I can't tell just by eyeballing it. How did I know that? Well, because this box, the box part of the box plot, has one standard deviation below the mean and one standard deviation above the mean. So and these little whiskers out here, those are going to be two standard deviations below. And so that indicates how many are in that group. And what these little dudes are out here in the middle of nowhere are outliers. These are ones that lay way out there. So we see that somebody made a lot of money on their pig, so they probably didn't invest much but got a lucky return. So then we can go ahead and run our ANOVA farm products by return per animal, click OK, and we can look at some of these means. So the means between cows is the mean is about 5.5, horses 10.3, pigs are almost 15. 14.95, but we've got some wobbling standard deviations going on with pigs and horses, and so that accounts for some of that overlap. it did happen to be a significant F value, so. Do the quick QF test. We got 0.95, comma 2, comma 105 for our two different degrees of freedoms. We submit, that's okay. We have a 3.08 F critical. We've got a 4.058 F obtained. So we had a significant test. So there's a difference in these groups. So we'd have to go in and do individual t-tests to kind of ferret out what the difference are between these groups. And we're not going to do that right now. I just wanted to show you how to do these amazing box plots. So thank you much.